Coming up on Sports Weekly, the very latest from UCLA football camp at Cal State San Bernardino. Plus, we'll check in with San Gorgonio High School product Nate Meadors. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. The UCLA football team has taken over Cal State San Bernardino. I'm Pep Fernandez, and this is Sports Weekly. The Bruins are back in San Bernardino for their annual training camp. The football team will be at Cal State for the better part of 2 weeks, preparing for the upcoming Pac-12 season. Head coach Jim Mora has another strong group of players, but is a Pac-12 title brewing for the Bruins? Coming out of Pac-12 Media Day, UCLA was picked to finish in third place in the Pac-12 South Division behind USC and Arizona State. Several of the key players for the UCLA football team this season have San Bernardino roots. True freshman Nate Meadors from San Gorgonio High School will look to earn a spot at safety, while San Bernardino native and Rialto Carter High School product Kenny Clark will anchor the Bruins' defensive line. The players are living on campus for nearly 2 weeks and focusing solely on football and their season opener on September 5th against Virginia. For Nate Meadors, it's his chance to shine and impress the UCLA coaches right in his own backyard.
It's going pretty good, you know. Coming in early for spring really helped me develop, and so I'm actually trying to help the other freshmen to what I know, and the older veterans are helping all of us, so we're all coming together and it's going pretty good.
What's been maybe the biggest challenge as you progress here at the college level?
Just knowing all the plays, knowing all the techniques and stuff like that, but once you get all that down, the game is much easier.
It's kind of cool to be out here in San Bernardino. I mean, look around, see family, people know.
People complaining about the weather, but I've been living in it my whole life, so, you know, it's pretty cool. But having family and stuff come out, be able to play in front of them, it's really cool.
And as we get closer to the official kickoff of the season, I mean, have they said, you know, hey, you know what, you're going to see minutes, get ready, you're going to get in there, you're going to play. But I mean, how did they see your role at this point?
Yeah. That was the whole reason why I came in spring, to try and so I could have a better advantage of playing this season. I'm actually running with the twos right now, so it's going pretty good, and we're just all going to progress as DBs and just keep working.
Bruins head coach Jim Mora called a quick timeout to give some high praise to Carter High School product Kenny Clark. He will anchor the defensive line for the Bruins, and Coach Mora was glowing about Clark at UCLA training camp.
Physically, he's, you know, more mature, he's bigger, he's stronger, he's more durable. He's always been a very good player since his freshman year. He stepped right in and he looked like a full-grown man. I think he just has a great grasp of what we're trying to do. And I think that, probably the biggest thing is just his influence on those around him. You know, he has great work ethic. He doesn't say a lot, but when he does, it's very meaningful, and the players around him react to it. You know, the nose guard is he's usually the unsung hero of any really good defense. You know, you have to be strong in the middle. And, when you see a guy like Eric Kendricks, and Eric could probably be the first guy to tell you this if you asked him, you know, so often Kenny would hold a double team and they couldn't get up to the second level to get to Eric so Eric could run and make plays. And any great middle linebacker wants to have, you know, the kind of guy that Kenny is in front of him, that's for sure.
All eyes have been on Cal State San Bernardino, hoping to get an answer on who will be UCLA's starting quarterback this upcoming season. Will it be highly touted freshman Josh Rosen from St. John Bosco High School, or the junior Jerry Neuheisel? That has been the biggest question mark at Cal State San Bernardino.
I love the competition that's going on. They all got their things they do well. They got, like all of us, right, got our strengths and our weaknesses. I'm really happy with the, we've kind of added a few things this year, and they really kind of absorbed that information pretty good. Now it's just a matter of reps, getting to a little bit of a grind, starting, getting some situations where you see who performs the best. But they've been awesome and very competitive.
Still to come on Sports Weekly, we'll check in with the Cajon High School football team and also the Citrus Valley Blackhawks. Plus, we'll hear from former Redlands East Valley star Chris Polk, who's now in the NFL with the Houston Texans. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. Well, thank you for watching Sports Weekly. You can check out the segments online anytime by simply subscribing to the IEMG YouTube channel. You can even leave a comment on the videos on YouTube. and we might even use them right here on the show. I'm Pep Fernandez, and we'll see you next time on Sports Weekly.